welcome to another exciting, action-packed hour of Smoky Mountain Wrestling. Professional wrestling the way it used to be and the way you like it. Hi, wrestling fans. I'm Bob Caudle, along with Dr. Dirty Dutch Mantell. And we've got a great hour in store for all you fans this week. In action right here, we're going to see the Rock and Roll Express. Jim Cornette and the Moondogs are going to be Dutch. That's bad for your health. The Moondogs, you know, they're barred from appearing on television in Smoky Mountain Wrestling. They're not licensed in Smoky Mountain Wrestling at all. We're going to take a look at a tape of Mike Furnish in training. Also, how about drawing for a Beat the Champ, huh?
Okay, my special deal in life is to draw for the Beat the Champ. And today, to keep down any pretense of impropriety, I'm going to stick my hand in here. And the man to face Tim Horner today will be... Killer Kyle will face Tim Horner today in the Beat the Champ contest right here on Smoky Mountain Wrestling.
And Dutch is going to have Down and Dirty. Wait a minute, Dirty White Boy.
Let me tell you something. I've bugged and pestered the promoters of Smoky Mountain. That's coming up today on TV. Me and primetime Brian Lee for the Smoky Mountain heavyweight title.
Fans, we told you it's going to be a great hour, and we're about ready with the action. Dutch, this is going to be a wild one.
A wild one.
Let's go to the ring, fans.
Weigh of 206 pounds from Roanoke, Virginia, Jason West. And his opponent, weighing 228 pounds from Ashland, Kentucky, Bobby Blaze.
All right, Dutch, we got two tremendous young athletes right here, Jason West and Bobby Blaze. A great match between two top junior heavyweight contenders, Dutch. Heavyweights, remember, you know, anybody under 230 pounds or 230 or under is allowed to challenge for the junior heavyweight title.
Well, Bob, you know, that might even put you in that category. You could pull on a pair of boots and a pair of ties, and you too could be a professional wrestler right here on Smoky Mountain Wrestling, because you do weigh under 230 pounds, and that is the weight limit.
Barely. But I think I would fit right in there, Dutch. I may try that sometime. Hey, you know, this is a great, great card of Smoky Mountain Wrestling fans. You heard some of the matches that we're going to have during this hour. These two young athletes in here right now, and Dutch, I tell you, these matches mean a whole lot to these guys.
Well, they mean a lot. I think it would mean a lot to Jason West, because he's been here on Smoky Mountain Wrestling before. Now, his one loss record really doesn't belie his ability. He's a pretty good wrestler, but Bobby Blaze is, and I'm going to tell the truth here, because I always tell the truth, but I'm really going to tell the truth here. Bobby Blaze is a up-and-comer, and he's been going great guns in Smoky Mountain since he probably first appeared here, what, 6-8 months ago?
That's right.
And he's done very, very well.
Good move right there by West. You saw him back up to his feet with that wrist. Let me tell you this before you say,
Well, I guess you're just going to hog the whole show.
No,
go ahead,
no,
Bob. Say what you got to say.
You know what Blaze is going to be doing, don't you, Dutch? He's going to be competing in a turkey title match with Chris Candido at Thanksgiving Thunder.
Bad mistake.
Bad mistake. Loser, by the way, is the champion. And the champion, he doesn't get a belt. You know what he gets, Dutch?
Yes, I do.
What is that, Dutch?
He gets tarred and feathered in the ring, and that's going to be a severe setback for young Bobby Blaze when he steps into the ring against Chris Candido, the WWA heavyweight champion, a belt that is still unrecognized in Smoky Mountain Wrestling, I might add, and also the U.S. junior heavyweight champion. Chris Candido, a first here in Smoky Mountain Wrestling, a two-time tandem belt holder, and is stepping in the ring against Bobby Blaze, and he may have Bobby Blaze sucking soup through a straw. A tremendous spinning heel kick by Bobby Blaze here on Jason West, and he had to stun him with that move there, Bob.
I think he may be impressing you with his action in the ring now, Dutch. You may have second thoughts about him and Candido, and West missed it as he dove right to the corner. Just in time, Blaze moved out.
Great move right there.
That bridge after that suplex. He's getting pinned for 1, 2, 3.
Great move by Bobby Blazer, a belly-to-belly suplex with a bridge, gets the win over Jason West. And okay, you little munchkins at home, let's take a look at it. He gut-wrenches him, takes him over. You see the bridge right there, referee Mark Curtis sliding in, 1, 2, 3. A big win for Bobby Blaze, trying to work his way toward Thanksgiving Thunder. And let's go to Bob right now, standing by with the Suicide Blonde, Chris Candido.
All right, Dutch, and right you 100%. What a great win that was for Bobby Blaze and fans. That shows you that Bobby Blaze is ready, he's prepared, and he's waiting on this man right here, Chris Candido, for Thanksgiving Thunder. I guess Blaze showed you something right there.
He didn't show me nothing. Once again, Smoky Mountain Wrestling has proved me right and proved that they're the most backward organization in professional sports. The most ridiculous thing I ever heard, a turkey title match. The loser of the match is the winner of the turkey title. And you don't get a belt like this. Who cares about that? You don't get a beautiful belt like this one, a trophy, a plaque. The loser, the winner of the turkey title, gets tarred and feathered. So Bobby Blaze at Thanksgiving Thunder, you thought swimming in that river was something. Get ready to get tarred and feathered, you turkey.
All right, fans, Thanksgiving Thunder, it all comes down then. We'll be right back. We'll have more action after this.
If you'd like to raise money for your school, club, or civic organization, and you'd like to see the excitement of Smoky Mountain Wrestling live in your hometown, this message is for you. High school and college athletic departments, sports teams, police and fire departments, JCs, civic groups, or any group wishing to raise money can bring the stars of Smoky Mountain Wrestling to town for a night of action and receive a portion of the receipt. Write to us or call Sandy Scott at 703-989-6819. Smoky Mountain Wrestling and your civic group, an unbeatable tag team.
All right, fans, with me right now, here is the wild-eyed Southern boy, Tracy Smothers. And Tracy, we got our heavyweight title match, primetime Brian Lee and the Dirty White Boy coming up in just a moment. And you've got more than a passing interest in this match.
Boy, you darn gum right. Man, I tell you, that's a main event that sell out anywhere in the country. But, man, speaking for myself, the last few months here, boy, things looked awful bad for the home team, man. You know, you do your best and you go out and you give it your best shot, and sometimes it just ain't enough. And whether it's fair and foul play or not, you know, I can't make any excuses. I vowed to get the Smoky Mountain heavyweight title back, and doggone it, I just ain't got the job done. It's hard enough fighting a guy that's 6'6" and 280 pounds, but when you got that little two-bit tramp, Tammy Witch, it makes it double tough. But man, I want the winner. Yep. I don't care who wins. I don't care if they kill each other. I want the winner of that match because I want to get that title back where it belongs, around my waist and back in the South.
I can tell, and you can tell, too. You got a lot of fans here pulling for you. Yeah. They want the same
winner.
Thing.
I just want the winner.
Tracy Smothers, the wild-eyed Southern boy, wants the winners of this match, which is going to be coming up. By the way, it's going to be a wild match, no doubt about it, with the Dirty White Boy, primetime Brian Lee. Tracy, I got to ask you, will you stay right here with us at ringside?
Yeah.
Let's watch this match. How about doing a little talking with me during this match?
Well, I'll tell you what, you know, I know the Dirty White Boy's got a lot of fans now, Bob, but it's awful hard for me to accept him as a friend or as an ally, all the stuff he's done to me. You know, people have asked me, they said, do you like him? I say, no, I don't like him. I got no reason to like him. I got no reason to trust him.
All right, fans, right now, let's go to the ring. We're ready for action.
Challenger into the ring, making its way toward that square and circle, to use an old cliche, the Dirty White Boy, who's had a little bit of a change of face here in recent weeks.
Yeah, he sure has, Dutch, but I'll tell you, man, that's one tough, mean dude, man. They didn't give him that name, Dirty White Boy, for kissing babies. He's tough enough and mean enough to make a Brahma bull jump a barbed wire fence, like him or not, and I don't like him. All the stuff he's done to me, it's awful hard to accept the fella.
But this match is for the Smoky Mountain Wrestling heavyweight title. Introducing first, to the weight of 252 pounds, the challenger from Bucksport, Tennessee, the Dirty White Boy.
All right, and Tracy, Dutch, you were talking about the Dirty White Boy and the things that he's done to you. I tell you, in recent weeks, he sort of had some of the tables turned on him by primetime Brian Lee.
Oh, yeah. You know, that Brian, I tell you, man, like him or not, he's a big, strong guy, and he's getting to be one of the dirtiest players in the game.
Wait a minute. What's in the arm?
Oh, my God.
Here comes the champion, primetime Brian Lee, accompanied to ringside by Tammy Fitch, Tammy Witch, the first lady of Smoky Mountain Wrestling, as she likes to call herself. But he has a sling, his arm in a sling. Now, Bob, is this supposed to be a title match?
It's supposed to be a title match, Dutch, that's right. Tracy, what do you make of this?
Wait a minute.
I don't know, man. I know one thing, them two, they ain't conceded, they're convinced.
Let's see what Tammy has to say here.
Lord.
She has the microphone like she wants to say something.
What's he got,
something.
A sling on his arm there, Dutch?
We got to have an explanation here.
We need something.
Here it is.
Gosh darn our luck. Brian had a little accident the other day, and he hurt his wrist. He shattered his wrist into a million pieces.
Oh,
we have x-rays. He's in a sling. So, you know, I don't until then.
If you don't think that I want to hit a cripple, you're wrong.
Oh, heavens. And the dirty white boy, it didn't matter to him. And he went right at Primetime Brian Lee. Something fell out of that sling.
Hey, Bob,
it's a pair of brass knucks.
Yeah, they don't call him dirty white boy for nothing, man. That guy, he'd knock out his grandmother to win a wrestling match, especially to win that Smoky Mountain heavyweight title.
Primetime Brian Lee, though, had brass knucks in there.
Wait a minute.
She sprayed something
in the referee.
The
referee got sprayed.
Oh, and the white boy now has got Tammy Fitch.
Oh.
He's going to spike her.
Well, heck, whoop her, man. You whoop me enough, whoop her. You got the chance.
There it is. There's one, two,
and here from behind is Primetime Brian Lee with a tail.
Yeah, he's a backfighter. He's a backfighter.
Wait a minute. Whoa. White boy's coming back on Primetime.
Now he's got the towel around Primetime Brian Lee's neck. They're going to try to choke each other to death.
Well, he's got the jet. Wait a minute.
Whoa.
There's Tammy Fitch. She has nailed the white boy with that purse.
I know that feeling. She's done that to me 100 times.
And now that gives Primetime Brian Lee a chance to come back. He's putting those big number 14s right in white boy's upper body and got him nailed down, pinned down close to the ropes.
He's wearing him out, didn't he?
Now,
with the purse. He slugs him with a purse, and dirty white boy hadn't got a friend in the world, Dutch. He's got nobody to help him.
Well, he has nobody to blame if he doesn't have any friends.
Well, hey. Let me tell you something. Like I said, I've said it 100 once. I said it 100 times. He has dampened my spirits. He's hurt my chances. That man, you could write a book on what he's done to me. I'm awful sorry.
Look at this. Just
I'm awful sorry, fellas. I know he needs help, but doggone it, I just can't help him.
So
I don't
care. You're not going to help him?
No, Dutch.
Somebody needs to help him.
Hey.
He needs some help up there in there.
Bob, with all due respect, they can kill each other for all I care.
Wait a minute.
I'm out of
here. We got a fist. That's the dirty white girl. Wait a minute.
She just dives in it. Tammy Fitch takes her down.
Okay, fans.
And
Tracy Smothers has just left the broadcast booth. He is going back to the dressing room. Wait a minute. I think Brian Lee doesn't know how to handle this dirty white girl. He's like trying to get a cat off his face. Here's the white boy back.
There goes Lee through the ropes. All right, fans, we're going to try to get order restored. We'll be back right after this.
Fans, keep in mind, Smoky Mountain Wrestling is returning to Paintsville, Kentucky at Johnson Central High School Fieldhouse Friday, December 3rd at 8 p.m. with Fan Appreciation Night, all seats only $5. Pikeville, Kentucky, Pikeville College Gym, Saturday, November 20th at 8 p.m. You're going to see a Smoky Mountain street fight, Brian Lee with Tammy Fitch against the Dirty White Boy with the Dirty White Girl. And Thanksgiving Thunder is coming to Barberville, Knox Central High School, Saturday, November 27th at 8 p.m. And Thanksgiving night, we're going to be in Hazard, Kentucky at Memorial Gym with Thanksgiving Thunder. That's Thursday, November 25th, 7:30. Now, keep in mind, it's WYMT night. Kids under 12 get in for only 57 cents in general admission. In a match not sanctioned by Smoky Mountain Wrestling, the Rock and Roll Express against the Moondogs, and a gang fight match, anything goes. Jim Cornette's Heavenly Bodies against Ron and Don, the Bruise Brothers.
After all you welfare cases up there in Eastern Kentucky, right there in Hazard, Thanksgiving night, after the ceremonial traditional carving of the canned spam, I want you to come on down to the Memorial Gym. See the gang fight match. Bruise Brothers, it's your kind of match. You say you're street fighters? Well, this is your chance to prove it, because each man in the match gets to bring his favorite weapon. And it's legal to use it. Anything goes. The referee can't stop the match. And the only way to win is to knock your opponent out for a 10 count. And I guarantee you, Bruise Brothers, one way or another, we're going to do just that. And then I want to wish all the luck in the world to Tammy Fitch, because the dirty white girl being there at ringside, brother, the dirty white girl, Thanksgiving's nothing special to her. She gives thanks every single time the blood test comes back clear.
Thanksgiving night, Hazard, Kentucky. Primetime Brian Lee defending the Smoky Mountain heavyweight title against the dirty white boy, and he'll have the dirty white girl in his corner.
Thanksgiving night, I have to go and see the sleazy, slimy tramp across the ring from me. I'm probably going to regurgitate my Thanksgiving dinner. And Brian, please don't let her anywhere near me, because if she gets her hands on me, I'm not going to be able to go home and open my Thanksgiving presents.
You don't worry about anything, honey. You know, that's right. It makes me sick. After a holiday, we have to go and face Dirty White Boy and Dirty White Girl. I'll tell you what, Dirty White Girl, I know you're jealous of my manager. I know you want to get her, but you're not going to in Hazard on Thanksgiving.
Well, Primetime Brian Lee came into the ring with a pair of brass knucks. He was ready to really turn your lights out. But one thing I got to say, Tracy Smothers over here, we said you needed some help. You didn't have a friend in the world, nobody here to help you, but the dirty white girl.
You better believe it. Everybody thinks that the white boy's a man with no country. I have no friends. And I've done a lot of bad things in my career. but one person has always stood beside me, right or wrong, and I'm talking about none other than the dirty white girl. And Miss Tammy Fitch, I wouldn't want to be in your shoes. What do you got to say, white girl?
You listen up here, Miss Fitch. As long as I'm standing on the face of this earth, you or no other bimbo, as long as I'm around, will put your hands on this man. And if you don't think for one moment I won't rip your throat out and spit down your neck, honey, you better think again. I will go from one end of this country to the other side to kick your butt, you little bitch.
Wow. Strong word.
Tammy Fitch, I wouldn't want to be in your shoes for $1 million. But Primetime Brian Lee, what you've got to worry about is not the dirty white girl.
Tough guy.
You've got to worry about me. I've took a lot of big men. I've chopped every one of them down. I've put a lot of them out of professional wrestling. And by God, I'm still standing here. So what's going to happen, my dear friend? Thanksgiving Thunder, you are going to put that title on the line against me. And you want to guess what else? The dirty white girl will be in my corner at Thanksgiving Thunder. Regardless whether you like it or not, that's the way it's going to be, Primetime. So the best thing I can tell you and that bimbo little sluz is cinch it up tight. Come straight on, because the white boy and the white girl will be standing looking straight across the ring at you. And we didn't get the name, the dirty white boy or dirty white girl, by helping old ladies across the street. I got the name, she got the name, purely by beating people up. Now that is something you've got to learn to live with, regardless whether you like it or not. Let's rock and roll, baby.
All right, action. Let's go to the ring.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is a tag team match. Introducing first from Raleigh, North Carolina, Robbie Eagle and his partner from parts unknown, John Hitchcock.
Well, they mince no words, Bob. And I tell you, just or not.
You think the dirty white girl is after Tammy Fitch or what?
Well, I think she would like to get her hands on her one more time, maybe, in Thanksgiving Thunder. Maybe the time for her to do. I had women fight all over me from Maine to California, and it's always been a thrill for me to watch them tangle over my affections.
All right, Rock and Roll Express right here. And these two guys are really facing a challenge from none other than the big bad Boondog, Dutch.
Introducing from Memphis, Tennessee, at a total combined weight of 448 pounds, the Smoky Mountain Wrestling Tag Team Champions, Ricky and Robert, the Rock and Roll Express.
Well, Bob, now that we've had the introductions for this fabulous, great team, the Rock and Roll Express, let's talk about the team that I think might rule Smoky Mountain Wrestling for the next year, 2 years, 3 years, or whenever they decide to stop, they can go ahead and leave. And that's the Moondogs. You brought the Moondogs up. This team here, they have no rules. Now, nope. Smoky Mountain Wrestling.
They're not licensed to wrestle in Smoky
Mountain. Well, you know why? Smoky Mountain Wrestling's afraid of them. They're afraid they're going to come in here and they're going to bust open their fair-haired boys. They're going to bust open Ricky Morton and Robert Gibson, which they will. They will. And they're not giving them a license and not even allowing them to wrestle on TV. Tell me what kind of fairness doctrine that is. Can you defend that?
Yeah, can you defend that policy? I can defend that policy.
How?
You can defend
it's indefensible.
You can defend it by the fact that the Moondogs are what they are, Dutch. They shouldn't be allowed, I don't think, in any ring anywhere.
That's your opinion.
Yep.
That's your opinion. It doesn't count because my opinion overrides your opinion, because I am the expert out here, not you. It is an indefensible position, and the reason I say that, I have a pre-law background, and I would like to argue this case in front of the Supreme Court, and you would lose.
John Hitchcock came in right into that arm drag by Ricky Morton. Double team right here. Good, hard, high knee lift right there by Robert Gibson as they made the tag. Gibson got him covered only for the count of two, and Hitchcock kicks out. Hey, Dutch, it's been a wild one already. I tell you, I can't get over the action that we had in that match, or what would have been a match.
Well, Brian Lee.
Primetime Brian Lee and the Dirty White Boy.
Well, Brian Lee came to the ring, supposed to be a title match.
Yeah.
With an injury.
He was trying to sucker the white boy.
Well, the white boy, now, I like white boy, but he sucker-punched him. He knocked him down, and he went after a man in a sling. Now, what kind of sportsman is that?
Can you defend that? Can you defend that? No, you can't.
Dutch.
Absolutely not.
You don't get into the ring, and you don't carry a pair of brass knucks into the ring. Double.
Wait a minute. Double punch by the Rock and Roll.
Hitchcock.
They're going for their signature move on Hitchcock. The double whammy.
And the timing on it is just tremendous, fans. 1, 2, 3.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the match, the Rock and Roll Express.
And they ruled supreme again. And right now, fans, let's hear more about Thanksgiving Thunder.
Wait just a minute here. I wanna show these fans at home here. Don't ever override me, Bob. You see the signature trademark, the double drop kick. That might work on that John Hitchcock, but let them hit a moondog with that. Them moondogs will swat them like water off a duck's back, and the Rock and Roll will be going down the moondog's hands in the air.
All right, fans, more right now about Thanksgiving Dunder. Thunder, what about that, Dutch?
That's good. There you go.
The second annual Thanksgiving Thunder Tour is coming Thanksgiving weekend to a city near you. Thanksgiving night, November 25th, Hazard, Kentucky at Memorial Gym, bell time 7:30 p.m. It's WYMT night in Hazard. Kids under 12 admitted for only 57 cents in general admission. Friday, November 26th, the Knoxville Civic Coliseum, bell time 8 p.m. Saturday, November 27th, Barberville, Kentucky at Knox Central High School, bell time 8 p.m. And Sunday, November 28th at Freedom Hall in Johnson City with an afternoon bell time of 3 p.m. Here's the complete star-studded lineup you'll see as part of Thanksgiving Thunder. The Dirty White Boy gets his chance for revenge when he battles primetime Brian Lee with Tammy Fitch for the Smoky Mountain title. The Bruise Brothers battle former friends Jim Cornette's Heavenly Bodies in a gang fight match. Anything goes, each man brings his favorite weapon, and falls don't count. You must knock your opponent out for a 10 count to win the gang fight match. In a match not sanctioned by Smoky Mountain Wrestling, the Rock and Roll Express face the Moondogs. The Bullet has accepted the challenge of the evil Kevin Sullivan for the Four Faces of Fear. In Barberville, falls count anywhere. In Hazard, it's a Prince of Darkness match. In Knoxville, it's a First Blood match. And in Johnson City, a Singapore Spike match. Will Sullivan get the Bullet's mask? Find out on the Thunder Tour. Chris Candido battles Bobby Blaze for the Turkey title. The loser is declared the Turkey champion and will be tarred and feathered in the ring. Daryl Van Horn unveils his Egyptian giant, Prince Karras, who will face White Lightning Tim Horner. Don't miss the second annual Thanksgiving Thunder Tour when it comes to your area. The Thunder rolls only from Smoky Mountain Wrestling.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to Down and Dirty with Dutch. I'm Jesse Helms, and you're not. My special guests today are the very unpredictable, outrageous team of the Bruise Brothers. But before I can talk to them, let's look at this little musical tribute I put together just for them. I did this. Watch it, and then we'll talk to them.
Sit and listen to my records all day, with big ambitions of when I could play. My parents taught me what life was about, so I grew up the type they warned me about. They said my friends were just an unruly mob, and I should get a haircut and get a real job. Get a haircut and get a real job. Clean your act up. Get it together like your big brother Bob. Why don't you get a haircut and get a real job? I even tried that 9-to-5 scene. I told myself that it was all a bad dream. I found a band and some good songs to play. Now I party all night, I sleep all day. I met this chick, she was my number one fan. She took me home to meet her mommy and dad. They took one look at me and said, oh my God, get a haircut and get a real job. Get a haircut and get a real job. Clean your act up and don't be a slob. Get it together like your big brother Bob. Why don't you get a haircut?
great tribute to the Bruise Brothers. Guys, step in here. Now, you've had some troubles in the past, but I want the Heavenly Bodies are next on the agenda, and I just want you to tell the fans of Smoky Mountain exactly what you got planned for them.
All right, let's get this straight. Jim Cornette, you got a gang fight match with us. You're a pretty little boy. You're running around with two pretty other little boys. This ain't a wrestling match. This is a gang fight. It took a lot of guts for you to come into a bar, to come down where we run, where we conduct business every day. We fight every damn day of our life. Jim Cornette, you had guts to come get us. So now, you climbing in the ring with us for a gang fight. You try to control us. You underpay us. You treat us like garbage. Well, boy, let me tell you something. You look at my face, you look at his face. And damn it, if you think I'm kidding, you take a closer look, because I'm finally gonna get my hands on you and the Heavenly Bodies, and I'm gonna kick your as far as I can kick it, because I've been waiting and waiting. I've had time off. You've done everything to me that you shouldn't have, and by God, I'm coming for you. And don't think I'm playing. This is an all-out fight, and I'm coming.
All right, fans, there you heard it from the Bruise Brothers. We'll be back in 120 seconds. Don't go away.
If you'd like to raise money for your school, club, or civic organization, and you'd like to see the excitement of Smoky Mountain Wrestling live in your hometown, this message is for you. High school and college athletic departments, sports teams, police and fire departments, JCs, civic groups, or any group wishing to raise money can bring the stars of Smoky Mountain Wrestling to town for a night of action and receive a portion of the receipt. Write to us or call Sandy Scott at 703-989-6819. Smoky Mountain Wrestling and your civic group, an unbeatable tag team.
All right, fans, right now, Jim Cornette and that whistle and the guys that we've been hearing an awful lot about. No wonder these guys are not licensed in Smoky Mountain Wrestling. There's a perfectly good example of why.
Let me explain something to everybody out here right now. Smoky Mountain Wrestling is trying to protect some more of their fair-haired boys. I got the Moondogs from the swamps of Louisiana. I brought them all the way to Smoky Mountain Wrestling for one reason, to finish off the Rock and Roll Express. And what does Smoky Mountain do? They say, these guys are too wild. They're too crazy. We deny them a license. They have denied them access to hotels, motels, restaurants. They've barred them, tried to have them arrested. Well, let me explain something. Nobody does that to Jim Cornette or any tag team that I want to bring to Smoky Mountain Wrestling. Because what do you do? What do you do, Bob Caudle, when you got somebody on your property and you don't want them there? You sick the dogs on them, baby. And that's exactly what I'm doing to the Rock and Roll. Now, wait a minute, boy. Wait a minute. Now, they say that the Moondogs cannot wrestle on Smoky Mountain Wrestling, but I see a couple of guys in the ring right now. Why can't we wrestle them?
You can't wrestle. Jim, why? You know why not.
Why
the
not?
The guys are not licensed. They can't wrestle in Smoky Mountain.
You know what? I'm going to give them a license right now. Moondogs, sick them.
No, Jim. No. Jim Cornette said sick them, and the dogs went tearing out after him in the ring. And in the ring, we got Johnny Wild and John Patterson. They get in with a cheer. Oh, my heavens alive. A trash basket, a chair. And Cornette keeps blowing the whistle. Dutch, look at the guys in the ring. They got a little bit of everything in there. Outside of the ring now, they've got Wild and they got Patterson. Here comes Cornette. He's got even a, look, heck fire.
What does he have there?
Cornette looks like he's got a vacuum cleaner. He just throws it up into the ring. I guess he wants them to vacuum the ring.
Did Cornette just give them a license to wrestle here?
He can't do that.
Well, he just did. They're in the ring.
Oh, and they just burst that right across the head. Look at that trash can. That metal can, how bent up and beat up it is. Look at the vacuum cleaner, Dutch. No.
You see that, Bob Caudle? He's cleaning up the competition. He's cleaning up with that Hoover, just like we're going to clean up the Rock and Roll Express, because
let me tell you something right now. Nobody's wilder than the Moondogs. Nobody's meaner than the Moondogs. Every dog needs a bone to chew on. And the Rock and Roll Express have got two big bones right up their legs that the dogs are going to maul and chomp on.
Oh, my heavens, call them all.
Hey, now maybe Smoky Mountain Wrestling will listen to me when I say when I want a license for my team, I'm going to get it. Rock and Roll Express, Thanksgiving, meanest, most evil tag team of all time. And they're also the wildest. They're uncontrollable. And only I have the key. The key is the whistle, Bob Caudle. The only thing that calls them off.
Enough's enough.
They're every dog.
Right into the floor.
Every dog likes fresh meat. Come on, dog.
And finally, there's Cornette again blowing the whistle. I can't believe it. He's finally going to call him off, Dutch. It's unbelievable what they did to those two.
Well, first of all, he said every dog has his day. The Moondogs are having their day today. And he also mentioned rock and roll. Look at this. This is your future.
And now Jim Cornette's going to bring him right on over here.
I want to do an interview. Hey, mister, are you glad? Are you glad you're in the wrestling business, huh? Are you glad you're in the wrestling business, huh? I don't think they're so glad they're in the wrestling business. Hey, Ricky Morton, right here. This looks like Ricky Morton. Ricky Morton. That's Ricky Morton. And that's Robert Gibson. Watch it, dog.
Should be barred. They shouldn't get a license. They ought to be put under chain, lock and key, and in chain.
Come on, dogs. I'm going to find you a fresh bowl of water and maybe a nice cat to chew on.
Jim Cornette and the Moondogs fans. Unbelievably wild from these two. All right, as you know, let's... Fans... The Bullet is meeting the challenge of the Master Kevin Sullivan in the Four Faces of Fear Challenge, and that's going to be at Thanksgiving Thunder. Right now, let's take time to hear these words from both participants while we catch our breath.
Well, everybody's wondering what happened to the Bullet. He got toasted like a marshmallow. But at Thanksgiving Thunder Part 2, Kevin Sullivan, alias the Master, and you too, Cornette, I'm gonna be looking at both of you. You see, you burnt all the hair off my eyebrows, you burnt my eyelashes off, and I won't be seeing right for a couple of weeks, but I don't have to see right. All I've got to do is see an image, and I'll know that little fire plug, Kevin Sullivan, when I see him, and when I get my hands on him, you're gonna curse the day that the caveman invented fire, because that fireball's what's got you into this mess. And I want you to please do that voodoo that you do so well at Thanksgiving Thunder. Because I'm going to chew up your voodoo dolls, and I'm going to spit out splinters. James E. Cornette, I know you're behind it, brother, but you tried to take me down before, and you couldn't do it. And thank goodness the Bullet has come to save Bob Armstrong. He's let me use his gym here, so I'm getting ready. Before all this mess is over, Bob Armstrong will be commissioner again, and I'll tell you what. You've got about as much chance as a snowball in Hades of taking this mask off Thanksgiving Thunder. I'm glad the Four Faces of Fear are your favorite matches, Kevin Sullivan, because that's what I want to beat you at, your own game.
Why would a full-grown man run around in a mask? Only if you're Bob Armstrong and want to hide from your four idiot kids would you do that. Bob, they know where you live. They're going to come over there and bother you the rest of your life. Sure, you made mistakes. Sure, you're going to have to pay for them. And you made a real bad mistake in my life. You didn't pay for my psychiatrist. You know, I was making real good progress. I was becoming a model citizen. I was starting to feel good about humanity. I wanted to be the next Dr. Do-Good. I wanted to find a cure for cancer, or maybe a cure for the common cold. But now, on Thanksgiving Day, thunder, because of all this built-up hatred directed at one person, the guy that used to be the commissioner that wouldn't pay my bills, I have problems in my head, Bob. I have a big pain up here because the four faces of fear are whacking around in my head saying, reach in there and pluck out his tongue. Reach in there and pull off Bobby's mask. Thanksgiving Day, Thunder, it's a tradition. It's like when the pilgrims invited the Indians over for Thanksgiving and they said, do you want a leg? Do you want a leg? I do. Thanksgiving Day Thunder, a family tradition.
Well, fans, that's strong words from the Bullet and from Kevin Sullivan. And Bullet has his work cut out for him to keep his mask and his health. And we'll be right back right after this.
Now you can have the Bluegrass Brawl, Smoky Mountain Wrestling's wildest event ever on home video. Witness the three-team street fight, the Heavenly Bodies against the Stud Stable against the Rock and Roll Express and Arn Anderson. Relive the magic of Tracy Smothers winning the Smoky Mountain Wrestling title. All matches complete and uncut. Send for a free merchandise brochure with tapes, shirts, caps, photos, and more. Write to Smoky Mountain Wrestling, P.O. Box 1279, Morristown, Tennessee, 37814. Order your merchandise today from Smoky Mountain Wrestling.
Fans, don't miss Smoky Mountain Wrestling next week right here on television. Our TV main event, we'll see Jim Cornette's Heavenly Bodies battle the Bruise Brothers. It's going to be wild next week right here on television, so you want to be sure you're here with us. Hey, Dutch, as you know, former University of Tennessee volunteer football star Mike Furness is in training in Smoky Mountain Wrestling Camp.
Big deal.
All right, I tell you what, fans, it is. And let's take this look at some of his progress by videotape.
Remember, Mike, on the collar and elbow lockup, keep your head up and go for the quick advantage.
Right.
Stand and switch. The guy's got his hands locked between you. Break it off and spin right into your switch, okay?
That's where I had that trouble breaking it off. You had a grip on me there. Really tight.
Yeah. Going for the hip toss, you need to get the arm in. Remember your leverage points behind the elbow.
Right.
And as you make the turn, make sure your hip's in. So when you follow through, you got your momentum going, and you've also hooked the elbow to get him over.
I remember that.
Come on. Get out of it. You can do it. Come on. First.
Compared to football, buddy.
I tell you what, I love it. You know, hard work is good for the mind and body. But I played a lot of football in a lot of different places all over the world, and this is a whole new challenge. You got to be physically in shape and all total body fitness, and I'm looking forward to it. It's hard work.
You know, I told you coming in, you know, it wasn't gonna be no easy road. You know, and like I told you when you came here, car ain't got no gas, ain't going nowhere, bud.
Right. I was on reserve a couple times today. He was riding me hard.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, this match is for the Beat the Champ TV title. Introducing first the challenger at a weight of 305 pounds from Hell's Kitchen, New York, Killer Kyle. And his opponent, the TV champ, at a weight of 230 pounds from Morristown, Tennessee, White Lightning, Tim Horner.
All right, fans, and of course, this is Tim Horner's first defense since winning the title last week. But Dutch moving in with us right now is Daryl Van Horn, and we've been hearing from him in recent weeks about Prince Karras, I believe it is. But I tell you, I got to go back. You're talking about how rough and tough the Prince may be and what he might do. I think you just got an eyeful of what may happen to anybody in Smoky Mountain Wrestling when Jim Cornette had that wild bunch out here just a moment ago. Have you ever seen anything like that?
That's nothing compared to what Prince Karras is going to do at Thanksgiving Thunder. Thanksgiving Thunder is going to be hotter than a jalapeno enema. And why? Because Prince Karras will make his debut against that punk in the ring right there, the people's champion, Tim Horner. Well, Tim Horner, look at the people you represent. They're a bunch of backwards hillbillies who speak in tongues, handle serpents, and drink strychnine. Well, Tim Horner, you should have listened to the doctor when he told you that drinking strychnine would stunt your growth. Look at you now. You're 5 feet tall, 150 pounds, and you're gonna get in the ring with a 7 foot tall 350 pound giant. And the amazing thing, Bob Caudle, is that there are some wrestling pundits out here saying, well, he knows the sweet science of wrestling, he might be able to pull off an upset. Well, cancel that right now. It's kind of like Ron Jeremy once told me, when you're huge, who needs technique?
Well, there may be something to say about that, Dutch. I see you're agreeing with that.
Oh, well, he's making a lot of, he makes a lot of sense, and he has a man he's bringing in, and he's highly touted, and I think
I've never seen him. I don't know a thing about him. Do you?
When Daryl, I know a lot of things, Bob. I don't let out everything I know on this television set, but if Daryl Van Horn says he's bringing the man in like that, then I have to take him at his word, and I believe him. And I'm sort of sorry that it's going to be Tim Horner that he's making his debut on, because Tim Horner may not be with us very much longer after Thanksgiving Thunder. Right, Daryl?
Exactly. And you believe this, Bob Caudle. When you see Prince Karras, you're going to be in for a bigger shock than you would have if you watched one of Michael Jackson's home videos. He's incredible. He can't be stopped. And I'll tell you something else about Tim Horner. He's had an unremarkable wrestling career. The only reason he's been able to do anything here in Smoky Mountain Wrestling is because he's willing to kowtow, play step and fetch, and kiss the butts of the promoters here.
Absolutely.
In Smoky Mountain Wrestling.
Right.
Well, you will
right.
never find Prince Karras or myself kissing a butt unless it's been properly beaten and bloodied by a cat of nine tails first. Nobody looks good wearing brown lipstick, Tim Horner, and you look absolutely ridiculous, and he's gonna knock it off your face at Thanksgiving Thunder.
Ooh, I tell you,
that's
right
some
now.
Strong words.
Yeah,
I like you, Daryl Van Horn,
a man
who tells it like it is.
Catch your breath just a minute, Dutch. Let's do a little business. Fans, if you'd like a personal appearance at your business from one of the Smoky Mountain stars, call Pam Lawson at 615-587-1273 to arrange it. That's Pam Lawson. Give her a call. And now, let's go back
Analyze this match here. Here is Tim Horner going into probably the most important date of his life, Thanksgiving Thunder, against Prince Karras.
That's Prince Karras. Prince
Karras. But he is not looking like he's really ready to go. He's not looking like he's peaking.
My gosh, look what he's in there against, Dutch.
But,
a giant
how
of a man
much bigger is your
Kyle.
Man than Killer Kyle?
What, a foot taller? A foot taller
a
and
foot
a good...
Taller.
100 pounds heavier? What's Kyle, 260?
I got 305.
Well, he's got 50 pounds on Kyle and a foot in height.
My heavens alive, that's got to be like a giant in a ring, Dutch, if he's that big.
But he is that big. Do you think Daryl Van Horn is sitting there just telling us a lie, Bob?
No, but maybe he's using a stretch tape.
Why don't you just call him a liar to his face? He didn't mean that, Daryl. I apologize to my co-host here. He does not know what he speaks.
He had Horner high to the air, but he couldn't slam him to the mat that time. Kyle held to the ropes.
Wait a minute.
Look at this by Horner.
Reverse sunset, got him.
He would never do that to Prince Karras. I'm going to tell you what.
The winner of the match and still Beat the Champ TV title holder, White Lightning, Tim Horner.
Well, Tim Horner successful in his first defense here on Beat the Champ. And let's take a look at it. He goes for the, see that, fans, kids, don't try this at home, but he goes for the sunset, reverse sunset flip. Mark Curtis in for the count, 1, 2, 3, and Tim Horner, $1,000 richer. Let's go right now, ladies and gentlemen, to Bob Caudle, standing by with our Beat the Champ, Tim Horner.
All right, Dutch, and here with me right now, White Lightning, Tim Horner, another $1,000 richer, still our TV champion. But I tell you, we had Daryl Van Horn over here talking about Thanksgiving Thunder, and he said we have probably seen the last of White Lightning.
Well, let me tell you something about Mr. Van Horn. Mr. Van Horn is a leech, just like all these other managers around here, trying to find somebody that'll take him to the top so he can ride their coattails and be somebody. Well, I've heard all about this prince of wherever.
Harris, I think he
wherever he is, coming in over seven feet tall, over 300 pounds, and wanted to fight two men. Is that correct?
That's right.
Well, let me tell you something. At Thanksgiving Thunder, you've got me, White Lightning, and I'm going to be coming at you so hard and so fast from so many different directions, you're going to think there's two of me. I hope your man is up to the test, because I sure am.
Oh, boy, fans, Thanksgiving Thunder, it's really going to be something, and that's something, by golly, you don't want to miss. We're going to be right back right after this.
Wrestling fans, Smoky Mountain Wrestling is coming back to Paintsville, Kentucky at Johnson Central High School Fieldhouse Friday, December 3rd at 8 p.m. with a fan appreciation night, all seats only $5. Pikeville, Kentucky, Pikeville College Gym, Saturday, November 20th, 8 p.m. You're going to see a Smoky Mountain street fight, Brian Lee with Tammy Fitch against the Dirty White Boy with the Dirty White Girl. And Thanksgiving Thunder is on tour in Kentucky in Barberville, Knox Central High School, Saturday, November 27th at 8 p.m. And Hazard, Kentucky Memorial Gym, Thursday, November 25th, 7:30 p.m. Thanksgiving night. It's WYMT night. Kids under 12 get in for only 57 cents in general admission. You're going to see a non-sanctioned match, the Rock and Roll Express against the Moondogs, and in a gang fight match, anything can happen in this one. Ron and Don, the Bruise Brothers, against Jim Cornette's Heavenly
Bodies. Well, it's like this. As you can see, we've been in the gym training, preparing for this kind of a match. It's a gang fight. The only thing is, we're kind of having problems figuring out what kind of weapon we want to use. They all working real good. You can see they working. We're running out of people to try them on. You people, come on out. Hazard, Kentucky, it's a gang fight match. We're going to get it on, and we're going to tear the place up.
Thanksgiving night, 7:30 p.m. Now, keep in mind, again, it's WYMT night. Kids under 12 get in for only 57 cents in general admission. You're going to see a Smoky Mountain title match. Brian Lee with Tammy Fitch against the Dirty White Boy with the Dirty White Girl.
You know, everybody's going around saying the white boy's a man with no country. He has no friends. Well, I've done a lot of bad things, but right or wrong, I've always had one person that stood beside me through thick and thin, and that's this little lady right here. So Thanksgiving Thunder, Turkey Day, it's all coming down. And White Girl, what are you going to do if that Tammy Fitch touches me?
I'm going to show her what a hazard it's going to be to her health. You show up in Hazard, Kentucky, honey, and I'm going to kick your butt like it's never been done before.
There you have it, Turkey Day. It's all coming down. Prime time, I'm taking the strap, and they just ain't nothing you can do about it.
All right, fans, and with us right now, here's Primetime Brian Lee, Miss Tammy Fitch.
Ridiculous.
What? Well, you guys were really trying to sucker the Dirty White Boy, or what? He didn't have an injured arm.
Who does White Boy think he is bringing that sleazy little tramp out here? Who does she think she is touching me? I mean, I can't believe the Smoky Mountain officials would even let somebody as dirty and sleazy like her in the same building with me. I'm going to get a skin rash from her even coming near me for her touching me. I can't believe this. She's the sleaziest, dirtiest, I'm so upset. She's the sleaziest, dirtiest little tramp I've ever seen in my life. She's a scumbag. Hey, Brian, can we say the word slut on television?
I think we can. That's exactly what she is,
Bob. That's what she is.
That's exactly what she is.
That's what she is.
Dirty White Boy's nothing, and she's nothing but a slut.
That's what she is.
That's what I know. I know. She hit my head right here.
Brian!
Oh, wait a minute. Watch out. Oh, and there she goes, up over the desk. Brian got her, and Brian tackled her. Here's the Dirty White Boy. We got pandemonium right now. Fans, it's been a while, and it's been a woolly one. We got to go for now. See you next week, and until then, so long for now.